here. AKA Coach Ballgame is as he's known. He runs baseball camps for kiddos. The main one is located in the OC. He encourages kids to love baseball, reminds them that, you know, it's supposed to be fun when you learn the game. Well, just last week, I want to tell you, Fox Sports ran this bit from his camp and reacted live on air. Take a look.
Rookie cookie, mac and cheese, raising Arizona, just like A-Rod, Big Poppy, the Big Hurt, T-Train. Everybody at our camp gets a nickname. All right, guys, this is the Attaboy Challenge. Whoever screams it the loudest wins.
Coach Ballgame! Attaboy, attaboy. Hey, I'll tell you what. Poppy, I think the segment is over, but thank you very much.
No. It's important to feel good. We're on a baseball field where Kirk Gibson hit a magical home run. Sandy Koufax threw a perfect game in 1965. Ben Scully's up there somewhere. I just want to snuggle up on the outfield grass.
I want to snuggle up on it too, but we got to stay off the grass or that's bad luck. So let's talk about your camps for these kiddos. Kids as young as 4 years old can go ahead and register and be a part of this.
That's right. I want to start them young because I want to give them the bug. And I want to let them know that when they see a baseball field, it's incredibly fun. It's like a birthday party. I want that to stick in their brain. And then when they go play, they're not worried about pressure. There's no expectations to succeed. You're supposed to have a lot of fun. So I throw drum sets in the on-deck circle. I give them all nicknames. It needs to feel like a birthday party.
You know, the other thing that I love about your story is that determination is key in whatever you decide to do. I read a little bit about you that you wanted to go pro. You wanted to play baseball. And did you ever get the call?
No, didn't get drafted. Didn't get a call, except for my dad. After I didn't get drafted, he said, "You didn't get drafted." And I said, "I know." But that's when I put everything aside and said, I think I'm meant to teach kids the game of baseball. And so what I'm doing is just making sure the next generation loves the game.
What's been the response?
It's been great. I've got a handsome man named Joe Buck, who's I've partnered with, and Jason Patrick and Cool Fire Studios, and they want to create a TV show where I travel the country and I spread the good word of baseball,
and it's been understanding the game, not just for the kiddos, you guys, but this can also be for the adults. I have never really, I was going to say swing a ball. That's not correct.
Sure, you
throw a ball.
Throwing a ball, swing a bat, spit on the ground, all that. That's baseball.
I'm a rookie. So can you show me a thing or two? I got Alex standing by. Alex, watch out.
Well, here's the deal. With throwing, the first thing we teach the kids, you don't want to get earwax on the ball. You don't want to push the ball. If you get earwax on the ball, it's not very good, right? So you want to raise your hand like you're in class.
Okay.
I call that teacher bell.
Got you.
And then you got to release it out front so you flip a light switch off. Flip the switch.
Got it.
You create that backspin, no earwax.
Okay. All right. So let me have
I'll hold this. You do that.
Okay. All right. Here we go. I got the ball. I got the glove. This is mitt, glove.
And no pressure. Whatever happens, you're going to get an atta girl anyway.
You're only kind of nervous and getting warm. Okay, ready?
So raise
it. Like a teacher.
No earwax. Perfect.
Okay.